Hello, mate. Yeah, it's Rich. Two B's and a white. Yeah, where are you? All right, mate, I'll be there in about 10 minutes. I'll ring you when I'm there. All right, nice one, mate. Bye.
Right, we need to find the cat. Oh, Rich!
It's quite open here, isn't it?
Oh, so you need to do it up in that hill.
The riverside, I have to go in the riverside.
No, I'm not. I'm going all that way. I'm doing it here.
No, you can't.
Yeah, we are. People won't care. It's going to take us 2 minutes, Rich.
Stupid you are.
Look, in this way.
Come on. You're the one who wanted to go here.
Rich, can you get them?
Just come.
I can't.
Oh, my God, you're pathetic. Come on.
Did pick the most awkward place.
This is quick leaving.
Do you know what I mean? I told you it was stupid. You got water, yeah?
Yeah. How is it stupid? Like, no.
Just get everything up.
When you do crap, you always do this.
I'm impatient in that, do you know what I mean? I'm not.
You are, babe, you are impatient. I'm not going to lie. So what? No one's perfect, darling.
Bad habit. It's an expensive habit. I spend like £200-300 a day easily. I'm living on the streets and pretty much every bit of money I get goes on gear.
I know it's wrong and I know it's bad, but I do enjoy it.
A lot of things need to change in the way we treat drugs in this city, in this country.
I've got surgeons, I've got lawyers, I've got doctors, a huge amount of young professionals.
Nick! Open your mouth. Don't swallow the drugs. Spit them out.
In the next slot up, my love, like there, where you are now, and then put the money in the top right, the coins or or card in there, my darling.
Thank you.
Well, thank you very much, sir. Thank you. Someone might say, "What did you do last Friday?" I could tell you what I did last Friday because I did the same as I did today. Every day is the same, so. Basically go begging or sometimes shoplifting or whatever to go and get some money.
Oh, I see they're just not going in.
Sometimes you have to put them through a few times.
Oh, right,
okay. By about 11:30 or whatever, we've usually got enough money to go and score. Get back about 12:30.
Door's closing.
And all day for the rest of the day then is literally making money. Going to school, doing the drugs, making money, going to school, do the drugs. In Bristol, we got this team called like Streetwise, and basically, it's the council and the police working together to combat begging and rough sleeping in Bristol. They've put an ASBO injunction thing on me, so basically saying I'm not allowed to beg in Bristol, I'm not allowed in certain areas, but I still go there anyway.
He told us he was on nearly a grand a week.
That's what he told us.
Oh, thank you very much. Right. Liz. Thank you. Okay. Cheers. Have a good evening.
You get people and they will give them a £10 note right in front of you. Well, if he's getting sort of that sort of money regular, it soon tots up.
The team's made up of a bloke from the council called Richard and a copper called Mark.
Our job isn't specifically to target people for drug possession. Obviously, if I find it on them, I would deal with it. But Streetwise was set up to stop antisocial behaviour, and a lot of that is focused around the begging. It is an offence, and we know that the money from begging is 9 times out of 10 used to fund an addiction of some sort.
Usually, you'll get one sat there. In the knocks, and they're up the road. You've got the Hippodrome down the road, you've got the Auto Academy place next door, and that generates the most public. So these are the entrances that everybody comes in to collect the cars.
Oh, thank you, my darling. Cheers. Thank you. Have a good evening.
There's another pay station just through that door there. That's another favourite spot. All they'll be up on level 8. So, depending which one they're on, it'll be how many flights of stairs we've got to walk up. So. Richard, he's the carrot, the carrot and stick, if you like. He's the fluffy side, and then I'm the stick side. Somebody's here. If any arresting needs to be done, that falls down to me. But we go down the route of support and offering them support before we start to use enforcement.
Doors opening.
Sure, what about £3?
We want to get them onto their prescriptions, because until we take away the need to make the money to fund the drug habit by way of that script, the prescription, then we're not going to get them out of the car park.
Ah, oh, no way. Did he come to arrest me?
What for?
Oh, because you said, oh, good, well, you all right?
Do need to speak to you and Jolene.
To me and Jolene?
Yeah, it'd be easier to just do it all together.
All right. Not resting.
So he's got your bag down on level 1 then? Got your bag down on level 1 with the sign?
That's mine.
That's yours, is it? Right, I'm Rich, are you getting a script?
To be honest, I haven't started the process yet.
You've not started it yet?
Well, I need to.
Well, I understood you were saying you weren't speaking and didn't want to do the script.
Right? I didn't say I didn't want to be on the script. The reason I haven't is because It's just crap life, so that's why I haven't. But I know that I need to, and I do want to get on one, really. All you care about is getting money and getting better. They're not going to appointments. So if I make them for the afternoon, that's where I think I'll go wrong, because they always seem to make them early in the morning. Right?
So why don't you at least go and register this week?
I will, yeah.
So you don't have to be doing this, and then get an appointment with the doctor.
You need to go in and see them.
It's an hour-long assessment, isn't it?
Yeah, they'll do the assessment. And then they'll script you from there, depending on the assessment.
Yeah.
Right, so we can't leave you here, and you are in breach, so we're going to kick you out.
Yeah, I'll sign up with the doctors, all right? All right, see you later.
We want to get them onto their prescriptions, ideally at the same time. That way they can sort of support each other, become a bit less chaotic, and try and get clean together.
How much have you got? About £7, isn't it?
£7.10, I think. It's dead as well. Look how dead it is.
So I'm saying. I'll see you in a bit, all right?
Well, I love you. I'll
see you in a bit. Just cheer up. It'll be all right.
No, it's not going to be.
Well, you. Just pretend it is then. Just smile.
I'm cautiously optimistic.
I'm too cynical.
I don't know why.
The trouble is that they're making so much money here, even on a script, they're going to miss the money.
Whether or not they don't come back begging remains to be seen, basically.
But if she does, we just keep putting the breaches in and then we'll take her to court on the warrant.
So you're going to get a brew? Oh,
I think that's a good idea.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you, Cheers. I was younger and I was about 13, some older bloke gave me heroin for the first time. It makes you feel just nice, you know, just dreamy. I know it's wrong and I know it's bad and I know it's shit and that you shouldn't do it, but I do enjoy it, that's the problem.
Morning. Time to move on. Right.
Joe. Hi.
Get on, isn't it?
Yo, we switch. Yeah, can I come see you for two bees and a white? Yeah, go on.
Yeah, what, you mean Kensington Park?
All right then, cool, I'm on my way, man. All right, bless. Give me that money, Joe. Give me that money.
Yes, Richard, I'll give you the F-word money.
All right, I'll be as quick as I can, all right?
Yeah, it'd be better if you could run. I think the misconception is that homeless people and heroin addicts and that just swan around being off their nut all the time. They don't understand that you actually need it to keep well. Come on. Because if you don't take it, obviously, you know, then you start to rattle, like the stomach ache, the sneezing, the everything hurts, you feel sick, you've got no energy. You know, you literally do it to be well.
I'm sweating.
Yeah, I'm sweating as well. Do you want me to do it? No, don't do it with a nice T-shirt, baby. I'll give you something else. And please don't drop it.
Hi, Becky, it's Richard Hawkridge from the council, Streetwise. I'm calling with regard to two people who we've been trying to support get onto a methadone script.
Right.
A chap called Richard.
Right.
He was meant to be coming in early this week in order to get an appointment with the doctor. I just wanted to see if he'd been in to do that.
Sure, bear with me a moment.
Cheers.
There isn't any record of it on the...
Where's my cardie? I know you're tired as well, darling, but I'll take over from you as soon as I get back. Yeah? Do you know what I mean? Like, we'll have a good bit of money then, innit?
Good luck, baby.
Okay, yeah, baby. I love you so much. 3 years ago, before I come to Bristol, I had two jobs. My son living with me. It's a three-bedroom house.
Ooh.
The only thing was my ex was violent. He was very controlling. He was getting worse and worse, and he ended up stabbing my friend up really, really badly. If you've got so many problems in your life that you don't know how to start dealing with them, you just want someone to come along and wave a magic wand and it ought to be sorted out for you. That's what heroin was, you know, it was my magic wand.
Please mind the door. Doors closing.
So when was the last time you used?
About an hour ago.
Yeah.
Going up.
Over the last 4 weeks, used every day?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Doors open.
And what sort of quantities have you been using?
I mean, like £300 of a day, like ridiculous.
Okay.
No, like loads.
Is that just on gear or is that crack as well?
About 200 on gear and about 100 on crack. Like, minimum amount is like £200 every day.
Okay.
It's stupid. When I had my son, I was clean and all that. So, yeah, I didn't even smoke when I was pregnant. It's been my mum.
Okay. How often do you see her?
I'm not at a mix, so I use it, but as soon as I go on my script, then obviously.
Sure.
Oh, I miss her so much.
Have you ever been in a domestically violent relationship?
Yeah, that's what I got moved there for.
And have you ever experienced, other than that, physical or an emotional abuse at any time in your life?
Yeah. When the domestic violence thing happened, I ended up getting moved to a refuge. My son stayed with my mum. He didn't want to come because he was obviously at school. So basically, I was plucked from everything that was keeping me stable. My job, my house, was all of a sudden all taken away from me.
So at the moment, there is a housing problem?
Yeah, as in, there is no house.
OK, so you're currently sleeping in the car park. Have you got any movement on sort of any housing?
Well, no, as soon as we're both on scripts, we'll start looking for private rent, because I've always had my own house. Like, I don't want to go into, like, hostel or...
Sure, yeah.
I just, especially if we're trying to get clean, even if it's just, like, a room in a private rented house to start off with and, like, build ourselves up, so... Yeah.
You're looking to go on Subutex, the Norphine. When do you think you'd go into withdrawal today? Because what we normally do is we'll give you two milligram tablets.
Yeah.
4 milligrams to take away and use when you're in withdrawal.
Yeah.
And that's a starting dose, getting it into your system. And then you can have that and then go into the pharmacy tomorrow and get your 16. Does that seem...
Yeah, that's cool.
Nice to meet you. I'll see you soon. Yeah. Take care. Bye-bye.
What are you doing now? Come here.
Yeah, no, this is why I don't pack anything up.
Right, let's go.
That's not him. No.
Yeah,
that's Rich.
That's
he knows damn well he shouldn't be in there.
Yeah. If he's keeping up there, that's just taking the piss.
Yeah.
It wouldn't have been so bad if he'd have found somewhere else to kick, but he's not even bothered, has he, so...
And he knows that they'll have him at the night shelter there while they assess them, but, of course, they're not going to want to go.
They're not going to get him together. It'd be separate, won't it?
No.
How much money you got?
We need to get 11.
We need to get 11 quid.
You should sit down here a minute while I've got to level 8.
It's dead down here, Joe. There's no cars here.
Kidding. Yeah, but people will come through, don't they? They don't just come through to come here.
The council housing team have had a referral for these two.
But
because they've arrived from out of town, they have no local connection, so there will be no offer of a flat or a house.
I made some inquiries, and she's fleeing domestic violence. She's got no intentions of going back, you know. To be honest, I can't blame her. She may well have been, at some point, removed by the police and put in a safe house, but it just didn't work out for her.
We don't know what the images are from today. We won't get that till tomorrow. Mm.
Mike, you been in Trenchard lately?
I've been there today.
He was in there today? What a muppet.
I'll go and find Rich in the morning. Tell him that if he turns up at the station, you can arrest him. Take him straight to court.
All right.
Saves him from being in custody over the weekend.
OK.
What time are you off? 5?
No, it's 4:30, she wants to get away.
I'm quick, I could get the 4:15 bus.
No, she's on the wine tasting tonight, so she's on the runner.
Come into Bridewell at 10.
I thought it was Magistrates Court.
You'll have to be arrested first. If you don't come in at 10, we'll end up chasing you around, and then you'll come in whenever, and it'll be a night job.
Be
and
all that.
I say it because I have to.
I do appreciate the way that you've done it. And that,
Cool. Bridewell, 10 o'clock. Right. Yeah? Is that doable?
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah, sound.
I'll definitely do.
All right. See you at 10.
See you later.
I just don't trust him. I don't know. I just got a bad feeling, man.
I was just being paranoid, probably.
Yeah, OK, right, see you later.
I haven't been paranoid. Well, I'll see you in a bit anyway. I'm going to walk down there, right? I was a good kid, really. I, like, always did everything to help out my mum. Do you know what I mean? I was a good kid. I did good at school, because I was winning top sets and that. Where it went wrong is, like, one of my neighbours was getting a bit bullied at school, quite bad, beaten up and that. So one day in the changing rooms, I stuck up for him, then I started getting bullied. Arranged to meet him there at 10, so he knows what I mean. All right, thank you. There's like 20 kids chasing me, kicking my head in. I had like big footprints in my face. And this was going on like every day. But it got really bad to the point where I tried to kill myself and that. I was only like 13. Took loads and loads of tablets. Turned out they weren't what I thought they were. They were like some special vitamin things. So they didn't actually do fuck all. And, like, I just woke up the next morning, I was still alive. I was like, oh, for fuck's sake, I'm still alive.
Morning. Right, there was a warrant issued on the 26th of August. Right, for alleged breaches of injunction. So I'm arresting you at that. That's 10:25. All right, so you don't have to say anything, but Mel's offensive. You don't mention ring questions, something which you'll let when I got. Anything you do say, maybe give me evidence. I'm going to stick you in that van for 5 minutes. It's like baby steps to try and push him towards accepting the help that's on offer. And then a lot comes down to the individual on how badly they want to kick the habit and how badly they want to progress on with their life.
You don't want to be doing this when you're 30 or 40 years old, because we're finding a lot of people now and they're doing it at that sort of age and they're having health problems, whether it's a leg cut off or they're dying.
You know. Sadly,
it's horrible. And in normal life, don't get me wrong, I'm not dissing you. But you would have a decent job because you come across well.
When I get sorted out and on a script, I want to help other people to get off it and that when I sort it out. Yeah, I want to like help, especially like young people, because it's just such a waste of life, man.
Well done, we're all booked in.
All right, thank you.
Cheers, bro.
He's on conditional bail till the 16th of September, 12 o'clock here.
Right.
So if he's caught pegging within this period, well, I'll be straight back in on a warrant.
Yeah.
So he's got to behave himself while he's on this bail, basically.
Cool.
Time for a cup of tea.
They said if I come back to this car park at all, they're going to send me to jail, yeah? But, like, the biggest step thing's, like, getting on the script,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah, of course it is. But then that's what's going to change everything for the future, isn't it?
Exactly. It's a bit shit we started at different times, really, but I wanted to do it for ages, but I just need to actually do it now. Really, it's a good thing about the police hustling us, really, because it's making us do it, isn't it? In 5 years' time, I want to be in a house, have a car, have a good job, maybe have kids, be, like, maybe get married and that. Do you know what I mean? That's what we want to do, innit? Just want to just be normal and sort it all out.
I want to go on holiday, we want to go to Amsterdam, don't we? That's the first thing we want to do, we get clean, innit, probably.
I said I want us to go to rehab, because I don't... It's going to be hard, even on the script, isn't it? It's going to be hard just to...
Yeah, but I think at the end of the day, like, you're always going to be around it. If you really want to do it, you'll stick to it. And obviously, we've got... That's the one thing that we've got is we have got each other, do you know what I mean? To support each other and that.
We've been together for, like, nearly 3 years now. I was 7 months clean. I was going to drug groups and that, and I was having a really bad day. And so there was a guy who was at my drug group, and I knew that he was still using drugs, and I said to him, can you get me some? Took me to this girl, and she sold me some heroin and that, and it was Joe. She's always said to me since, like, she feels guilty, because if she'd have known that, she wouldn't have sold it to me. And I said to her, listen, it's not your fault. Like, I'm a big boy, I chose to do it, do you know what I mean?
I love him so, so much. I never believed in marriage before I met Rich. I think, you know, we're meant to be together, and so that's one good thing that's come out of it.
That's the most recent. 9th of September, 20 past 10, night. Yeah. She's there. The 10th of September, 20 past 7. 10th of September, 20 past 10. 11th of September, 20 past 5. 13th. And then yesterday, the 14th.
Yesterday evening.
Now she's obviously just taking the piss and
making
a fortune out of the public. But even if she's on a script, she's still going up the car park and she's still flat out begging. I think her time's up.
Yeah.
It might seem a bit unfair to be arresting Jolene. She's now on a script. Although, what really concerns us now is Richard's not on one. For him to still be using drugs in front of Jolene, she's going to find that extremely hard. And we've got to think, well, is it time to split them and give her a chance to get properly clean in prison, give her that opportunity to have a clean break? Good morning, all. Right, well, you know what we're here for, I presume by now. All right, it's 10 past 8. Right, so you don't have to say anything, but ma'am, if you don't mention when questioned something which a little on iron caught, anything you do say, they'll be giving evidence. You see your breeches.
What's the point? I actually sorted out my script, sorted out the house.
Fair enough, you might have got your script, but you've been in here every single day since, which is still breaching the injunction.
As soon as my script's due, I'll wait, will I?
But you said that last time, and you're on it, which you've been on it for a week now, and you're back in it all the time.
A week? I only started my script properly on Friday.
Yeah, and it's Friday now, the 9th you got it.
Come on then. You're on the same, you're going straight to court anyway. You're still coming down 12 o'clock for you, isn't it?
Yeah.
Is there any medication that you need to bring with you?
No.
Have you not got
any?
And this bag, have you taken this bag with you?
Yeah.
You got your book?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm just going to go over the top. Okay. And then what I'm going to do is just go through the middle, make sure there's nothing in the middle.
Yep.
All right. Okay. That's fine. The jeans are a check, don't you?
Yep.
Just check.
They are a very close couple, which is quite rare to see in the street community. But we quite often see a couple, one will disappear inside, and then the other partner is off with somebody else while they're away.
Richard's due in court today as well, just before Joe.
If they're a couple, the judge might bang them both up.
But so maybe a bit of time away from each other might help.
It might do. It breaks up that routine that they've got at the moment, doesn't it?
Yeah.
When I was in court, the solicitor for the council is some bloke who sounds like he's been kicked in the bollocks. He's got the most annoying voice. Not only had I breached, but they had CCTV of me cooking up a bag and banging up in the stairwell, so they weren't very happy about that.
He got a 28-day sentence suspended for 6 months on the basis that he goes to that appointment at BDP on the 23rd of September.
So they decided to give me one last final chance. And then as I was leaving, I heard they was going to be bringing Jo in.
She's in prison. She was kind of like, oh, you know, if you send me to prison, then I don't care, that's fine, but it's just going to set me back. What's the point? I hope Rich sees his script through and that I can get the drugs team to sort her out.
She said, oh, my God, I can't believe I'm going to jail and you're not. So I gave her a little wave, like a little sarcastic wave, like, bye.
She was, like, flicking the Vs and mouthing fuck off towards Rich, so I don't know what that was all about.
To my beautiful wife, Jo. I'm so, so sorry I upset you in court. I didn't think about how cunty it was to wave to you like that. Looking back, I know it seemed like I didn't care that you was getting sent down. I hate the way things were left between us. I feel so bad, babe. Honestly, I'm so sorry. Please forgive me. You're my baby girl and you always will be. I'm so scared that you are going to start thinking you're better off without me. I know I'm a cunt sometimes and I'm moody and I give the impression I don't care about you, but I really do. All I want is for me and you to get clean and have a normal life. You make me so happy, even when we are homeless and smackheads, so think how happy we can be when we're sorted. And I get my script on Friday, I'm sticking to it. We can both be clean when you get out and life will be so much better.
So, do you know what meds you're wanting to go on to?
No, methadone.
Methadone, yeah? So, at the moment, how much are you using?
Loads.
Loads?
Like, yeah, probably 8 bags a day.
Eight bags a day, yeah. And crack as well?
Yeah.
Yeah, and is that about the same?
No, probably double.
Is it? Okay. Yeah. So, how old were you when you first started using?
Crack was about 17 and heroin about 24.
Yeah, okay. So, in terms of your mental health, have you got any major concerns around that?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I've got schizophrenia in it.
Okay, right.
And it's it's been bad lately.
Yeah.
Not sleeping at all, really, or anything.
And would you say it's sort of worse at the moment than it has been?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. So what we do today is we'd start you on 30 mils.
Yeah.
Okay, we do that for about 5 days.
Yeah.
So because you're currently homeless and sort of nowhere safe to store the methadone, we'd probably look at 7 days supervised.
Yeah, yeah, that's fine. Okay. Cheers, thank you.
No worries.
Thank you.
All right, take care.
Bye. See, they have to start you on 30 mils for 5 days. That ain't gonna do fuck all.
Round four.
I need you, babe. I miss you so much. I can't wait to see you. Love you so, so much. For now, just keep it real behind the steel and just chill out. I hope it's not dragging like it is out here. You're my life, Jolene. I love you, my little egg. Can't wait to hear from you. Loads and loads of love. Your stupid, sorry husband, Rich.
Sweet. Mwah.
No reason to be begging, he's on his script. And he obviously still is, so
he's just taking the mick out of this injunction.
I think he's got comfortable in the car park, hasn't he?
Routine, comfy. Make a lot of money in it, that's the problem. He's just got this little bubble that he's in and he's bursting.
He's not aware Jolene's out today, he thinks she's out tomorrow.
Can I put this in the back of your car? Yeah. Is that right? Because it's a bit heavy.
Glad you've only got the one. We've had people come out with five before.
Well,
she's been picked up from prison by a charitable organisation. They've given her a lift back into Bristol. They're going to sort her out with a few basics to get her back on her feet.
I don't have have any proper shoes. Like, these are, like, literally got holes in and that. I don't know whether you help with shoes.
Bit of clothes shopping, bit of toiletries. No doubt take her for a big breakfast. For her safety, I'm not going to arrest Richard today. I think at this stage, he can look after Jolene, being a lone female. No doubt, you know, she's got nowhere else to go at the moment. And if he's on his script, that should negate him having to use. We've got the warrant. If he relapses, we can go and execute that. But we're going to give him that chance and see how they go.
Richard?
Yeah?
Morning.
Oh, you're not going to take me down, are you?
No.
No, not now.
No, no, we're not taking you anywhere today.
You managed to get much sleep last night, Richard? Yeah. Proper ill with his fucking flu, isn't it? Flu, is that?
No, is it flu or is it because the script isn't big enough at the minute?
Well, hopefully, if my script goes on today, I won't have to use it at all. I've been using the steel because my script's ain't heavy, but only like one or two bags compared to like the 8 or 10 I was doing before. Hopefully, today, 10 mils, that'll be enough, I won't have to use it at all.
Got some other news for you as well, reference Jolene.
This organisation are picking her up in a car and then bringing her into Bristol. Because Eastwood's out in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah.
So she's detoxed while she was in then, was she?
I don't know if they took her off it, I don't know. I thought they put her on a small amount and then slowly brought her off it. I'm not sure though.
We've kept it open for when she comes out, but she's got to go at 2:30. Make that appointment to say, right, I'm here now and I want to carry it on. If she misses it, it's going to screw her right over.
Have you been able to speak to her much while she's been in there?
I sent it. Sheila sent me some letters. I sent her some letters, but because I'm a fucking idiot, I forgot to put all my name and that on it. So they sent her letters with stamps on it, saying you're not allowed to send anonymous mail. So my letters haven't been getting to her.
Right then, get yourself together.
He knows. But he's going to know that we're going to be after him soon. So unless they get a private rented place, which is going to be extremely difficult for them to do, because a lot of private landlords now won't touch DSS clients at all. They're going for the students. It's an easier option. And housing's just drying up for people like those two. Everybody deserves to be housed. There's just no housing left for anybody. You know, you can't even house people that have lived here all their life, like a lot of people that come in expecting to get it all.
I hope Jolene carries on and gets the help that she's already been getting and continues with that.
Well, it's there for her. She should be stabilised now because she's had 2 weeks up there on a script. So we'll see what happens when Jolene rocks up today.
Yep.
It'll be interesting to see where they kick tonight.
Thank you, my darling. All right. Do you do, like, lattes and cappuccino or whatever?
Lattes or coffees.
I went to prison for walking through a car park. They're ridiculous.
Stuff for you.
Oh, thank you, ladies.
It's put together by one of the churches that we work with. So
fair play. Thank you guys so much.
Lawrence Weston, do you know where that is?
Yeah.
It's not really central, but
no,
it's...
but it's quite far, isn't it? But it doesn't matter because if we're going to stay clean.
When you're ready, I'll press call and then...
Thank you. Hello, is that May? Hi, May. My name's Jo. I'm calling up about your spare room. May's step above the shop in Lawrence Weston. Sorry, I'm afraid I can't make it tomorrow. I'm working.
It's weekend, then.
Oh, it's the weekend. How about Monday? OK, then, May. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye. Is that Richard? Richard, it's Jolene. I've just rang up to look at a room in Lawrence Weston. I'm ringing up a few different places now to look at, to try and get accommodation. I've got my script, I've got everything, you know. I wondered, is there any chance that you could give me a lift? Because I don't know where it is. You or Mark? On Monday at 5:30.
Yeah, okay.
Cool. And I think my mentors are going to help me try and get like a cheap £10 phone later on today, so we'll have our own phone as well, okay?
Alright.
Thanks, Richard. Bye.
Do you feel like you want change?
Yeah. I also wouldn't have done all that today, would I? If I've got somewhere to live, yeah, I'm not going to be out going doing that because I'd rather stay in, read a book, do my nails, you know, get a little bit of volunteering work. See, that's banging. I think that's...
I thought that was really nice.
If I wasn't on the streets, I'd love them. But
love them.
Can you ask her and see if she... Oh, they're not bad. I need a belt because I'm going to wear that as a dress. I'm thinking of things I can multi-function. I like that one. Oh, thank
Good
you.
Stuff.
Thank you, Lindsay. The Tesco mobile phone shop is just there. Don't park in the NCP. So expensive. Oh my god, and they're cunts in there. They chucked all my stuff away. Thank you so, so, so much, honestly.
Yeah, it's got to come from you, hasn't it? The mentor will just help you to think about where you want to go and encourage you, support you. They're not going to do it for you.
A shit day, and then you say, come on, Joe, you've done really well.
Yeah.
That can do a lot of good, you know what I mean? Thanks for not writing to me, and thanks for not sending me no money.
I've got no
money off you, and nothing.
Don't start, look. I didn't write my names on the letters, I forgot.
Anyway, monkey me.
They sent a thing. Oh, listen, they sent a thing. Stamps saying, you smell all cheese, and saying, I didn't. They sent me a thing saying I didn't write my name on the thing.
I love you so much.
I thought you weren't going to come back.
Oh, I can't believe I cunt you was in court to me, babe. That
I'm
was
sorry.
Nasty.
Well, Elle did write you a really nice letter.
Oh, you'd rather have that, would you?
No.
You can't film now because he's got a boner.
Well, I guess you're coming this morning to wake me up. Mark and I've got irritations before.
I spent all day, I sorted out my benefits, I got paid today already.
Yeah.
I sorted out us two places to go and visit. Guess who's taking us, Richard, from the council and sorting out the money to pay for it. I spent all day from 9 o'clock this morning till now. You look nice.
I'm all sweaty.
They bought me £100 worth of clothes. I got a phone with £30 worth of credit on it. Everything.
So much bad stuff happened for years and you ain't let none of it out. I told you before, when you bottle everything up, you should know from me it made me go nuts, do you know what I mean?
I'm worried, I'm so scared I'm gonna do something bad.
I'm not gonna let you.
I'm scared, baby, I've never been scared.
Joe, everything's gonna be fine. For a start, we need to get out of here because I'm not coming in here anymore.
No.
We're going to sort it right out. Yeah?
Please just don't. Please don't let me down. Please.
Well, I ain't done it, I promise you.
I promise you. Look how shit everything's been, yeah? We've still been fine together, haven't we? Do you know what I mean? We've always got each other and we're both on the scripts. We're going to get a house, yeah? We're going to stop living in fucking car parks.
Two of them,
yeah,
which we don't recognise, like these two, because he's described, but the fourth one hasn't been described, but we know who he is,
we do.
And he's definitely with him. And then you got them coming out on level 8 out of the lift. That's just a member of public, that is.
A member of the public must have been thinking...
Yeah, but they don't have a car parked up here. This one's interesting. You get them coming out the lift along here. You watch what he does. Look, they're creeping around. They're definitely not looking up and down. Definitely looking for him. Yeah. This is a stairwell that he's kipping in, and that's the other side. So he's going to go check that one.
So they've come out of that stairwell.
They've come out of the left. Yeah. So the one in the blue's obviously checked this one here. He's look, calling them back across. He's found him.
Ambulance services. Hello.
Hello.
My boyfriend was really seriously attacked by three guys. He's now going in and out of consciousness. He's, like, really, really pale. He, like, comes out loads of blood.
Do you mean coughing or vomiting?
Pooing, like, from his bottom.
Okay, and are you with him now?
I've just had to ask these people to use the phone because we were mugged and assaulted and they took my mobile and everything.
Were weapons involved or mentioned?
Yeah, they hit him with ball balls in a slot on the head, like, loads of times.
Is there any serious bleeding?
Not on the outside now, but I think on the inside.
Okay, I'm organising help for you now. Stay on the line and I'll tell you exactly what to do next.
Basically, if Joe hadn't called the ambulance for him,
he would have bled out.
He probably would have just...
He would have bled out there and then.
Yeah.
So, yeah, he was quite lucky that she did come back. That'll be one time that he'll be thankful that she was breaching her injunction.
Yeah, definitely.
But, yeah. He'll have upset someone. He'll be on a drug debt and it'll be you owe us this, so we're giving you a kick in and we're having your phone as well. And there'll be the mobile phone.
Yeah, yeah.
That's why you couldn't get hold of them for the appointment she made to view the flat with you.
Yeah.
He obviously knows who they are, but he's not coughing.
No.
And he's not willing to pursue any complaint whatsoever, so he's not going to go anywhere.
No.
It's going to make it a lot worse for himself, isn't it?
He's going to get a lot worse, I suppose.
Can you imagine taking you going down there with your little one, and he's having the living crap kicked out of him.
Yeah.
So, just re-emphasise as well, we can't be having drug taking in car parks or begging.
And now he's in hospital, well, Jo's going to be
on her own,
basically, isn't she? Not sure where she is, last seen on the centre.
Mm.
I don't think she even went for the script appointment.
Are you here tomorrow?
Yeah.
I've got a spare
duvet
at home.
Oh, thank you.
I'll bring it in tomorrow.
Oh, that'd be brilliant. Thank you, my lovely. Anything like that spare that you have, or if you've got any clues, you don't want to sort anything, because I've got nothing now.
I'll bring in the spare duvet. I'll use it. It's just over my head.
Of course I won't, my darling.
I'll
see you tomorrow. Oh, thank you, sweetheart. Thank you so much. Take care.
See you later.
Thank you.
We've just learnt that Richard has discharged himself from hospital after his assault. I think Jolene's got a part of it. He doesn't like to leave her on her own. And we've learnt he's back in the car park sleeping rough, which isn't going to do him any good whatsoever. The warrant at last has come through.
Okay.
For both of them. I think some people might find it hard to understand, but if you know, you give them that break of putting them away in prison for a few weeks, they just need something to break that cycle. So he's got a minimum 2 weeks he's going to be gone for, plus hopefully he'll get a few couple of weeks extra. I would say he's definitely going to be better off in prison, because he'd probably be on the hospital wing still receiving that treatment that he needs. She's already done a 2 week sentence, so she should be looking at another. Don't we get a decent judge?
Yeah. Well, I don't think prison's a good place for anyone, but what else can we do? It worries me because when they're in prison, what's going to be the accommodation plan?
No, I don't think there's going to be any, is there?
Well,
unless they get fed up and they leave Bristol.
Yeah.
That's their only option they've got at the moment. Mm-hmm. Let's go see if there's a van. We'll go and find Paul and we'll go and drag him in.
Yeah, I was in a bad way and that. I was proper stressed out and that. I can't really imagine life without a really ugly shit. I was doing fine. But next day after she got out of jail was when I got put in hospital and that. When I came out, I couldn't get to my scripting back because obviously I was still so fucked up. And after 3 days, if you miss it, 3 days in a row, you lose your script, so that's what happened. Every time I either start sorting it out or get motivated to sort it out, something will happen that just like puts it all out the window, so just back to square one.
We got Jolene on the script first, and she was actually using it, and she said that she was staying clean, but she admitted she was finding it very hard when Richard was using in front of her.
Yeah, but whether they should split up or not...
Well, I don't think they should split up.
It's not, so. It's not for us to say, is it?
It's really? Not, no.
It's up to them.
But if they're going to do this, they've got to be doing it together, not one start it and then another start a couple of weeks later. Go on then, Joe, we'll take you up first.
Hi, I love you. Yes, in a bit.
Yeah. They've both been off of it before. Jolene was clean for 5 years and then she's got back on it. He's been clean for a while and then, you know, he's back on it. So he said, you know, they know they can do it.
Yeah.
Okay, right, time of arrest?
Was 18:30.
And place of arrest?
Level 8 Trenchard Street car park. Third biggest earner in Europe, apparently.
Judging by what I've paid to park in there, I can imagine.
Yeah.
Right, Janine, are you working at the moment?
No.
Don't laugh, I have to ask.
If you don't touch my bag, it's got pins in it.
Well, they will have to look through it.
Yeah, but just be really careful. I don't care if you look through it, but just be really careful.
Yeah, there's quite a few.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I mean.
Uncapped ones.
Where is there?
That one looks like it is. There's no orange top.
Oh, no, it's that's a Barrow Agent advert.
Okay.
But yeah, just be careful. Look.
Okay, there we go.
Do you have any illnesses or injuries?
Yeah, I've got an abscess on my arm.
Do you know what caused it?
Probably injecting heroin.
Her health has taken a drastic fall since she arrived in Bristol. She's going to be looking at open sores. She's, what, early 30s? Her skin's absolutely terrible, and it's all through the drugs.
How many needles was it?
29 in all.
I take my booties in with me, can I?
Yeah, the officer will have to flick through, make sure there's nothing in there.
I'm still a little bit battered. I've been in the hospital recently and had to have an operation and that. Okay. To like, have some of my spleen taken out.
So you had a ruptured spleen, lacerated kidney.
Yeah.
Is it all bruised?
Yeah. Oh, well, can't really see nothing on the outside, just inside, I think.
Yeah, it's weird. It's all been stuck to you, haven't they?
Didn't have no.
Make sure you get the nurse to have a look at that while you're here. I think Richard has hit rock bottom. You can see. Drastically lost a lot of weight. He's really sunken faced. The kicking that he's had in the car park, I think that's shaking him up. You know, he's realised that he could have died that night. And sometimes that is the kick up the arse that they need to actually start moving forward again.
So where are you injecting? Because you've just lost another bloody tissue down here.
Oh, I was in my groin.
OK. If you lift your foot up from
it, bleeding loads because they had to give me blood thinners in the hospital.
Right, okay.
The hope is that they, if we can get them a sentence that's the same length, they will be released together and they'll both hopefully be clean, so one won't be using in front of the other.
I'd hate to think about how much money I've spent on drugs. I'm telling you now, I could easily have paid for a house outright, easily. More than I could probably bought two or three. I mean, for fuck's sake, I could have spent that money on doing something good.
Shut up!
For a free poster with information about drugs and their effects on society, call 0300 303 3554 or go to the address below and follow the links for the Open University.
Sometimes it feels like fighting for, wasting away, fighting for.
Should have been, could have been, ain't so why bother with. No time to tolerate the constants of horridness.